New mayor laid out his agenda for his term, and many are saying it appears to be very different from the outgoing mayor, Kevin Faulkner. Joining us now to talk more about Mayor Gloria's agenda is former mayoral candidate and current chairman of Reform California, Carl DeMaio. Hi, Carl. How are you?
Good evening. Thanks for having me on.
Good to see you. So what do you think are some of the biggest differences between the priorities and the agendas of former mayor, Kevin Faulkner, and new mayor, Todd Gloria?
Well, you know, on a lot of levels, unfortunately, there are not a whole lot of differences. Kevin Faulkner has backed tax increases. Kevin Faulkner has allowed the city's budget to skyrocket higher with more spending, with not a whole lot of control and efficiencies. And Kevin Faulkner, unfortunately, has backed some of the onerous regulations that Todd Gloria now celebrates, such as the Climate Action Plan, which, again, will make things far more expensive in San Diego. More expensive energy, more expensive water, more expensive to actually start and manage a business. And so on some levels, there won't be big changes. But I do expect that we will see it accelerate from there. I think Todd Gloria has very little fiscal discipline. He's always out there talking about increasing the size of government. And it's clear that he's going to be talking about tax increases. Probably a sales tax is what they've been kicking around. And a sales tax would hurt working families. It's very regressive. I was disappointed today to hear that Todd Gloria and the new city council members, because we have a number of new city council members being sworn in, they all decided to take massive pay raises on day one in office in the middle of an economic downturn and pandemic. Todd Gloria is going to get a mayoral salary that is double what he's earned, what Kevin Faulkner earned. The salary is going to go from about $100,000 to over $200,000 today alone. And the city council member salaries will be increased from $75,000 to over $125,000 each. This is shameful. As small businesses are closing their doors, as working families are unemployed, the idea that our politicians are taking pay raises at the same time, no. They ought to lead by example and turn down those pay raises until we get through this rough patch.
I know this was a ballot measure, and I know that you have said that the title was misleading. Talk a little bit about that aspect of it.
Right. The politicians put their own pay increase on the ballot last year. And instead of describing it as measure, you know, L increases the salary for mayor and council by double, they said it would cut and limit the salary increases at City Hall. An absolute misleading and deceptive title. And so it got 75% of the vote in the election. Do you really think San Diegans of all political stripes would give the mayor and the council a massive salary increase? No. If they knew what they were voting on, they wouldn't. But here's the more important thing. No mayor or city council member has to accept that salary increase. When I was sworn in on the city council, they told me I had to enroll in the pension program. It's the benefit that's required. I turned down that pension on day one in 2008, saving taxpayers several millions of dollars just on my pension alone. So the precedent is there for council members to turn down salary increases and lead by example. Todd Gloria literally flat out refused the call to turn down that salary increase today. But you know what he did say? He said that he'd look at cutting his staff salary. Uh-huh. No, that's not what a good leader does. A good leader leads by example. Todd Gloria, don't take the pay increase. City Council, don't take the pay increase. Let's take a look at what's happening in our community and the economic distress that working families are experiencing, and let's lead by example.
How do you think he'll do on some of the issues we talk about for years, which is homelessness and the high cost of living here and the high cost of homes and rent, transportation, gridlock as far as you know, freeways and things like that?
Well, first and foremost, Todd Gloria doesn't want to deal with the gridlock on the freeways. He wants to cut the funding for the I-5 expansion, the 52 expansion, the I-8 expansion. He wants to raid those funds. He's already backed this proposal to raid the funds for highways and put it into transit programs in the name of what? Climate change. He also has backed those regressive tax increases that make it harder for working families to make ends meet. Gas tax increase, sales tax increase, higher water bills for residents. And finally, when we talk about the economic conditions in San Diego, Todd Gloria has presided over increased regulation of businesses time and time again that cost businesses money that would have ordinarily created jobs. We also see on homelessness that it's Todd Gloria who's had the biggest hand in the past 10 years in our failed homeless program strategies, where we're not holding homeless individuals accountable for the root cause of homelessness, which is mental illness and substance abuse. Instead, we're throwing billions of dollars of taxpayer money at failed programs all around the state of California, and here in San Diego, tens of millions of dollars in failed programs that simply say, here's a housing unit, but we're not going to require any change in their behavior to break the cycle of dependency. So I do not expect to see much progress on homelessness under Todd Gloria's mayoral administration.
Well, we'll have to see. It's day one. We'll have to see where he is in the next 3 months. Usually they try to put forth their agenda in the first 100 days. So Carl DeMaio, chairman of the Reform California. Great to see you, Carl. Thanks for all the information. Appreciate it.
Thank you.